Hello and welcome to the first RIG 2020 talk. I'm Steven Markham. I have just over 6 minutes to talk a little bit about the occult symbolism of Led Zeppelin, and there's a lot to talk about. The occultism within Led Zeppelin is mainly responsibility of one person, and that's the lead guitarist, Jimmy Page. Page is a serious occultist. He owned an occult bookshop in London. He's a big fan of this fellow here, Aleister Crowley. Even went so far as to purchase one of Crowley's ex-residences, the Leskin House, on the shores of Loch Ness. The occult symbolism is everywhere. The group's own record label, Swan Song, uses this symbol, said by some to represent Lucifer, the fallen angel. It's actually based on a painting by William Rimmer called Evening, the Fall of Man. Rimmer didn't specify what it's meant to depict. It could be Icarus, it could be Apollo, it could actually be Lucifer. In 1971, the group released their fourth album, and this is a sleeve opened out. There's no identification on it, there's no name, there's no record label, there's no album title. If you look on the inner of the gatefold sleeve, similarly, no identifying marks, just one illustration. The detail from it shows a hermit standing at the top of a mountain, underneath some villages and a few mountains. And you can see the young man climbing up the hill and a nice goat. I like goats. If you take the sleeve out, there is still no mention of Led Zeppelin at all. It is only when you actually take the record out of the sleeve that you will see Led Zeppelin written anywhere. But the album has actually been named. The names have been shown on the outer sleeve and the label. This is the name of the album. It's not Four Symbols, it's not Zoso, it's not Led Zeppelin 4, this is the official name. And Led Zeppelin even went so far as to send the font to the record shop so they could put this on the billboard to actually name the album. It took a try when Jimmy Page asked each of the group members to pick a symbol from a standard occult work, the book of signs by Rudolf Koch. Now, each one of them got a copy of the book, had a look through. Up first was John Paul Jones, the bass player. He went ahead and he chose a Trinity symbol, Pratiscus, which is a Trinity symbol of modern pagans representing maiden, woman, and hag. It's also used on the television show Charmed. It's on the Book of Shadows that the girls use in the show. Next, John Bonham, the drummer, had a look through the book. He chose another Trinity symbol. And this can be seen in the Thoth deck of the Talon, and there it is. And it commonly represents another trinity, Isis, Osiris, and Horus, the ancient Egyptian trinity. And in the book itself, you can see the symbols there. Next up was the singer, Robert Plant. And as was typical of Led Zeppelin in that time, the other two, having chosen the signs from the book, as agreed, he went ahead, looked through the book, threw it away, and chose something totally different. This symbol, which is not in the book, looks like the feather of a scribe, maybe, as he's a songwriter, it makes sense. It isn't, it's a very specific symbol. It's the feather of Maat, the ancient Egyptian goddess of justice, and this is the very same feather that Anubis waves against the heart of the dead person to see if they can pass into the afterlife and join Osiris. You can see the pot with the heart there and the feather in this illustration. Jimmy Page next. Again, Page, not one to pick something standard, decided on this symbol. It looks like Zoso, but they're not English characters. This symbol was taken from an 1844 book by Fenelon, and it's supposed to be representative of Saturn, and you can see it there with other symbols. It's much older though. This 1521 text of the red dragon with the black hen is actually the source of Fenelon's later illustration. And you can see by looking into this work, the symbol is listed alongside more signs all to do with Saturn. Now Saturn, in astrology, rules Capricorn. Page is a Capricorn, so possibly this makes sense. The work as well being Red Dragon, Black Hen, Page, very fond of red dragons. And his stage suit, the dragon suit, can be seen there. He's got the Soto label on his hip there, and has it on his speakers. And whether it's just a representation of Capricorn or not, who knows? The Hermit is another source of fascination for Page, and it's actually based on the Rider-Waite deck at the time, the Hermit card there. This in itself is based on a painting by William Holman Hunt, The Light of the World. Now, the illustration itself was called View in Half or Then in Light, and if you do view it in full light and reflect it in a mirror, you get quite a stunning image. And just take a closer look at that. That's the inner record sleeve reflected in the mirror. Now, there are four songs on each side, four singles naming the fourth album by a four-piece group. It's a modern spell, four being the tetrad, four as the name of the deity being very common. And that is the occult symbolism of Led Zeppelin. Thank you.